Every single year, we see guys break out in the NBA that the average fan never even knew existed, with these players usually being either second-round picks or undrafted guys that came into teams without any expectations at all. Sometimes players in this situation just fade away out of the league, and other times we see players use these situations as motivation to push themselves even harder and work their way into rotations. 2 days ago, I made a video about a player on the Toronto Raptors named Malachi Flynn, who seems to be ready to prove everyone wrong from a situation like this, and today, we're doing a similar type of video on a player on the Miami Heat. Funnily enough, the Raptors and Heat have easily established themselves as two of the very best organizations in the whole league when it comes to development of lesser-known players, so it shouldn't come as any surprise that both of them have yet another example of this coming through the ranks. But for today's video, the player on the Heat whose journey we'll be discussing is KZ Okpala. Okpala has looked incredibly impressive in preseason with the Heat so far, so in this video, we'll discuss what got him to this point, what kind of player he actually is, and how he projects as a player moving forward. Before we get started though, it turns out about 68% of you watching right now aren't even subscribed to the channel, so please, if you enjoy the content, consider hitting the subscribe button, as not only does it help out a ton, but I would also very much appreciate it. Now with that being said, let's begin. KZ Okpala's basketball journey began at the age of 4 years old, but unlike most children that get into the sport that early in their youth, he and his family shied away from joining organized leagues and club teams. Instead of playing organized basketball at that age, he spent a lot of his time outside playing at local parks and rec centers against people older than him, so he developed a much more natural feel for the game in a free-flowing nature of pickup basketball as opposed to the concise and practical styles of play that tends to come from organized ball. Throughout most of his youth, he was a ball-handling guard, standing at 5'10" when he entered high school as a freshman, and because of this, he's always had very good ball skills when it comes to handling it, bringing the ball up, making plays for himself and others, and things of that nature. However, after that freshman season, he began his massive 10-inch growth spurt, so all of a sudden, he found himself standing at 6'8", having always been accustomed to being a primary handling guard. As we all know, players that are 6'8" tend to be placed on the wing at the small forward position. However, especially in the modern NBA and the way the league is trending nowadays, players at this height that possess effective ball handling skills are more valuable than ever. So this was absolutely a blessing in disguise for Okpala. As he got used to his new height, he really began to break out as a top recruit in his junior season, where he won his league's Player of the Year award and led his team to a league title. Then, as a senior in high school, he emerged even further with a season posting averages of 30 points, 11 rebounds, and 2 blocks per game, leading his team to a California state title and once again winning the Player of the Year award. At the end of his high school career, he was a solid 4-star recruit ranked in the top 50 of recruiting databases, but he wasn't one of the top guys getting all of the attention, being named to McDonald's All-American games or anything like that. He committed to play for Stanford, which is a pretty good Division I program in the Pac-12 conference, but the thing about Stanford is that they have much higher expectations when it comes to your schoolwork and grades than most other Division I programs, and this came back to bite Okpala a little bit. Before he could even begin his freshman season at Stanford, he got suspended for the first 11 games of the year because it came out that he did not meet the grade requirements of Stanford from his final semester in high school. Now, in most cases that this happens, you would tend to think that it came as a result of the player completely slacking off and not caring about his schoolwork at all, but that's not the case with Okpala. What actually happened is that his schoolwork that final year included 3 advanced placement courses on top of his other classes, and he maintained very good grades in everything except for his AP Calculus class, which is a class, mind you, that most other high school seniors don't even take. This shows me that Okpala is dedicated both on and off the court, and he accepted the challenge that came with going to a school like Stanford, while most top recruits would choose a much less strict program where they wouldn't have to focus as heavily on their schoolwork. After his suspension was up, he did come back to the team, but his freshman season was pretty inconsistent, which is understandable because he had to get integrated back into the rotation mid-season, while the rest of the team had already gotten comfortable throughout the year. However, in his second season, with both a full off-season of work under his belt and the ability to start fresh from the beginning of a season, he really broke out and established himself as one of the best players in the Pac-12 conference, and NBA scouts began to take notice. That season, he put up impressive averages of 17 points and 6 rebounds per game. He shot 46% from the field and 37% from three. And following that season, he decided to enter his name into the 2019 NBA draft. Now, to get into the kind of player that Okpala is and was viewed as at the time, in his scouting reports from before the draft, he was always labeled as a crafty, highly skilled wing player who used his size and length, having a 7'1" wingspan, to his advantage on both ends of the floor, and he had the physical attributes to wow the scouts on top of those impressive ball handling skills mentioned previously. However, with all of these being said, you're probably wondering why he wasn't viewed as a top prospect in the class for a first round pick, right? Well, outside of that, a lot of scouts had worries about his shooting, which is where I think people began to nitpick way too much about his game. Despite shooting 37% from three, which is respectable, they noted his subpar free throw shooting and his previous season only shooting 30% from deep as reasons for why. But with all of this, you have to take more context into consideration. For one, he was a late bloomer as a player overall, as his growth spurt hit both height-wise and length-wise very late in his high school career, and getting used to that kind of length does tend to alter your shot for a bit. Plus, seeing him improve by 7% as a shooter from one year to the next should be encouraging, not discouraging, especially when he's at this age and continually getting better. Because of this, though, he fell to the second round of the draft, originally being taken by the Phoenix Suns before getting traded to the Miami Heat, and he spent a majority of last year down in the G League to continue his development, as the Heat were a pretty good team last year, having made the NBA Finals, so there wasn't much room in the rotation for him right away. This year, though, is a brand new year, and with a chance to prove he belongs at the NBA level, he's been wowing for sure. Against the Toronto Raptors, the team rested Jimmy Butler, because again, it is just preseason, so in to replace him in the starting lineup for the game was none other than KZ Okpala, and with this opportunity to show Coach Spoelstra that he deserves minutes this year, he went off. In the game, he scored 24 points, which led the team in scoring. He shot 9 of 15 from the field and 6 of 10 from 3, shooting it very well from deep and showing off a plethora of NBA caliber moves with the ball in his hands. He looks incredibly comfortable out there, and I genuinely believe he can be an impactful bench player in the short term, while potentially being a highly impactful player in a starting lineup further down the line. Of course, a lot of credit has to go to the Miami Heat development staff that have undoubtedly put in a lot of work to help him hone those raw skills he had coming out of college, but he also worked incredibly hard himself to get himself to where he is right now, and he certainly didn't take the easy route to get here. Once again, the Miami Heat are proving that there is talent available anywhere in the draft or even outside of it, and you just have to have the eye to see it. And with that being said, that's all I have for you today. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below what you think of Okpala as a player moving forward. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.